So to start off this project here, and we're going to be working with the figure, I want you to go ahead and get out your pencils from your kit. As you can see here, I have my array of pencils, as much as you can, obviously, or as much as you have. I have a couple of charcoal pencils here. You can see these are the red and blue are the graphite. I have a couple of erasers that I like to use when I'm drawing. Notice that I don't have my gum eraser because, you know, that's really only used on a larger scale. And typically with charcoal, we're going to be using graphite. So your white eraser or your brown eraser are going to be the ones that you're going to use. A knife or a pencil sharpener. I like to use just a nice sharp pocket knife because I like a different type of mark at the end of my graphite. And a pencil is going to give you just a real sharp line. So remember, I like to use both. A carved graphite will give you just a variety of edge, maybe a bolder line. And of course, if I just want some sharpness, I'll go ahead and use my regular sharpener. And you can see here where I have just a little scrap sheet of paper where I just have all my pencils here, and I have them labeled so I can kind of get a sense of which ones I could use. You probably can't really see the difference here, but when you do that, you'll know the difference just by feel, and also by tone. If you can see here, I don't know if you can, let me zoom in here, but the 2H here is going to be your hardest here. So you know, you can see that's even a kind of a gray tone, where your 4B is going to be the softest. And then on these aren't in any particular order here. I just grabbed them and just made a mark, so you can be as orderly as you want. But you'll notice just by the way, once you put that mark on, you'll notice a difference in the feel. And then that's going to make you think about, what can I use with whatever part of the drawing you're going to be using. And remember, you can mix and match. And I really want you to mix and match and go ahead and use all of them, just to get the feel of them, because we're going to be doing more than one drawing here, because when we're working with the figure, you want to gesture draw a few varieties of figures, and then we're going to choose one that we're going to then follow up on your larger 18 by 24 drawing paper. So we'll start off on the sketchbook to get a good a few sketches, and then we can then land on a solid idea, and then hopefully be able to transfer that idea onto a larger sheet of paper. With this assignment here, I'm going to really rely on your imagination, because or your own kind of rendering of a figure. So hopefully you have some ideas already about what figure you would want to do. Remember, it can be somebody that's specific. You can use references from photos or online. But I do want you to try what I'm going to do next. I want you to try this because I think at least attempt to try to develop a figure from your imagination. And let's see if that's really the way you can go. Instead of using a reference, by all means you can. But I do want you to do this part of the assignment in order to see if we can again land on a figure that comes directly out of your subconscious. So I'm going to go ahead and start off with my 4B. So as you can see, I'm got my pocket knife here, and I'm kind of taking off just some of that wood to expose just a little bit more of that graphite there, and that's going to help me just achieve a different mark. And I know this is kind of simple, but it really does make a difference when you begin. And sometimes that's the most important part of doing a figure or a gesture drawing, is kind of landing on a good first mark. So you make a good first graceful mark, something that you just enjoy, just a shape. And then that mark can then manifest into a head, and then a shoulder, and then on and on. So go ahead and see if you can just carve down, you know, a good, interesting shape, okay? And then we'll go ahead and begin. Okay, so I'm just going to basically start off with a few simple marks. And what I want us to try to do is to try to achieve a full figure on our page. So, and that's what a figurative drawing is that we try our best to achieve the full figure from head to the feet. Again, you might have to try this more than once. If you don't want to waste a lot of your sketchbook paper, go ahead and try this on just regular typing paper first, and then you can get kind of the hang of it. But I'm going to go ahead and just kind of begin to just kind of make some interesting marks there. Now, all I've done really is just kind of I've made somewhat of a head form, and that's just a quick gesture of something. And as fast as that was, right, you always want to just look at that. So let me zoom in here, because I think that already with what I have there, you know, there are some interesting possibilities of certain forms that I see developing that could be a lot of different characteristics of a head. And as fast as that was, right, I think that's what really creates the free shape and the free movement that can be real suited for a good figure, because, you know, remember, the body is never stagnant, the body is never still. And a lot of this stuff you do learn in figure drawing class, and this is not a complete figure drawing assignment, but it's a good introduction to how you want to draw a figure if you want to really create a fluidity of movement and the illusion of the figure gracefully, the presence of it being graceful and not robotic and not solid. So what I have here is a pretty interesting kind of set of lines. I can already see some interesting, features that then could turn into a lot of different types of, characteristics. But I don't want to kind of work on any detail yet. I just wanted to zoom in to show you that, it's probably not going to fully develop immediately. And that's why I really do want you to try your best to freely develop form with the mark that you randomly make. Now, I'm just going to continue on. Now, I know that somewhere within this scale here and here, there's a head, okay? Because that's where I decided to start. On the next drawing, I'll probably start somewhere else to just show you how I would start, if I started in the rib cage area or in the stomach area. But I'm going to go ahead and continue on here. And I'm going to go ahead and go, okay, well, if I have that, maybe there's, a torso somewhere. Okay, I need an arm. So I'm going to go ahead and continue on. And you can see how I haven't put my pencil down. And I really want you to try that. Okay? You don't need to put your pencil down just yet. We have erasers and everything. Okay? I'm going to go ahead. Oh, okay. See what happens down here. Okay, now remember, I want to be able to fit the full figure in. Okay, so I've done some gesture down at the bottom that includes the, somewhat a gesture of some feet. I want to think about proportion. I want to think about, I want to make it look somewhat, proportionate, meaning that the waist to the shoulders to the top of the head are somewhat matching. Of course, remember, this is a gesture drawing, so I'm not really worried if it's too correct, but I'm conscious of that. I don't want it to look too disproportionate, right? But now that I have kind of a structure of some sort, I can then go in, right, and possibly start to define some edges and define some more features. Again, I want to think about proportion. As of right now, I kind of see that my legs here are a little short, okay? So I'm going to pay attention to that. That means that I can probably make my head smaller to get things into proportion. So I'm going to go ahead and gesture one more time, but a little bit more careful. Again, I'm still using my 4H pencil. No, I'm sorry, my 4B pencil. But I'm going to go a little bit, slower now and try to think of more features. So, I want a neck. I got a chin here somewhere. Okay, I got a neck. Right, I want some pectoral muscles. I'm thinking about muscular structure, as much as, again, you want to. But you see how I'm starting to develop something a little bit more. Okay, rib cage. Applying more pressure now too. That's another thing, you know, I've started off with not a lot of pressure with that gesture drawing second set or second stage. Okay, let's get some, got some thighs here, there. Okay. All right. Over here, got a kneecap. Calf muscle. See how that goes here. I'm gonna, down here in the feet area, I'm gonna really still stay loose because, you know, I don't have to really go into a lot of detail down there. All right, so that was my second session, or my second gesture. And you see how I've developed a little bit more structure. I really want you to try to move that fast. Now let's kind of do a zoom in here, see if we can kind of observe some forms. It's gonna be sideways, but that's okay. I'll do a vertical shot later on, but let's observe kind of what happened here. And you can see how just within that quick layering, I'm already achieving some good tone as well, you know. It's there's some definition occurring just because of the overlapping, and you know, my hand was kind of rubbing as well. So I'm kind of enjoying what's happening. I think it's for now, it's a successful gesture. Again, remember, it's graphite, so it's very forgivable. So don't worry about if you mess up. I do want you to try to work through some of the mistakes, or some of what you consider an accident, instead of just starting all over. It doesn't matter if you mess up. It just matters that you are experiencing, you know, envisioning the figure or a figure as you are trying to dance in harmony with the movement of your hand and the feel of the texture of the paper and the pressure that you're applying to create that mark. All those things are happening in harmony because you're inventing something physically. You know, you're literally inventing something that never existed before. So really try to consider it in those types of terms. Okay. So let's give that a shot, and then we'll go to the next step. Okay, next step, what we're going to be doing is using your white eraser and just doing a little bit of editing. Now, again, I would like you to try to do these almost as swiftly as I'm doing them. We're going to go back and kind of add some more definition and detail and all of that. But let's go ahead and just do a little bit of editing with your white eraser. Again, remember, really consider your white eraser more of a drawing tool, like always, rather than just just to get rid of information. So I'm just kind of cleaning up some of these edges here, you know, doing just a little bit of shaping, defining. Now right here, you know, I have information that I want to keep because my hand's going to come down here. I'm going to do something when I add some more information later on. So I'm going to go ahead and leave some of that gesture there, but kind of just getting rid of some of the noise, right? Real simple, okay? Remember, we want these to be loose. We want them to have movement. There's tons of anatomy, stuff on that you can kind of look at if you want to look at some muscle tones and stuff like that. So by all means, you know, but remember, we're trying to do this in a gestural way so we can, have a lot more expression and a lot more inventive form. So I'm going to go inside the interior here and just do a little bit of work on the inside. Okay, again, just kind of playing with some tones. You can see how at some point that eraser starts to smudge things around, creating some pretty interesting tonal ranges and stuff like that. Just good stuff that later on we can then, you know, use as either use as shadow or tone, or get rid of. You know, we can get rid of it completely, but don't go too fast, you know, or in a sense, don't erase too much, because you want to leave some information on there for later on that we can start to add some more definition again, muscle structure, or whatever type of a character style you're going for. So I'm going to do a little zoom in here so you can see so what the erasing can do, how we can already start, it already starts to add some tones and definition. Again, we're going for more expressive figures here. We're going for more gestural figures. So you can see how already I'm getting some interesting things that are effects and results. So work with your eraser. Use it more as a tool to make marks rather than to just edit. Okay, so after you've done some beginning processes of gesturing and erasing, I want you to go ahead and quickly just turn over your sketchbook and let's start on the second figure. Again, I'm going to work with my 2B. I have another 2B here sharpened, so I'm sorry, 4B. And once I have my 4B pencil carved and sharpened, I'm going to go ahead and start. And I'm going to just see if I can do something a little bit different here. You know, again, I always want to start in an area. I'm going to go ahead and start in the head or neck area again. And let's see what happens when I start to just do a little bit more of maybe an expressive figure. Okay, so I'm kind of picturing maybe, you know, a hand, a head here. Keep going down here. Okay, see what happens when I start to add a little bit of maybe some yoga stance or something. Okay. All right. Or maybe kind of like a native, sun dancer or something. Those are great things to kind of look at before you just start is, you know, what are some things that you're into? You know, I love going to powwows and seeing just the color and the movement and the dances and everything that happens and the sound. So, you know, I take inspiration from a lot of those things. So you see how I'm kind of doing this figure that's kind of maybe crouching in this kind of warrior stance of some sort, you know, and there's my gesture. Okay. And remember, it takes a lot of just, while you're making the mark, it takes a lot of just envisioning the image. It's almost like a duality of experiencing drawing and the image that's in your mind. So maybe you should sit a little bit before you start your gesture and go, okay, I'm going to think of a position. I'm going to think of a place to anchor myself in a pose. Again, it could be a character of some sort, but you know, anchor yourself in a vision, with a vision of a pose, a position that to put your figure in, and then begin to make marks. Begin to concentrate on the mark, on the pressure of your hand, and then at the same time think of that pose, think of that vision, and you'll see that something will develop. And I think it's important to understand that, remember, it doesn't matter if it's perfect. It doesn't matter if it's even in full proportion. It doesn't matter if it's altered. What matters is that you're attempting to envision a figure and attempting to record that vision on paper. Now, how you record it on paper, okay, is secondary, because you can erase it, you can correct it, it's a forgivable material, you can manipulate it. So all that can be done after the gesture, but that initial experience is what's really going to get you that movement and that sense of it being a natural moving figure. Okay, something that's not robotic or stagnant. Okay, so I'm going to go back in now and just begin to do a little bit of defining. Of course, now I'm going to go ahead and just maybe anchor down some shoulders again, putting a little bit more pressure, but you know, trying my best to just provide a little bit more information, just more areas that are needed to just define a figure of some sort. Okay, thigh right here, outline. And the thing I like to do, if you notice, I start from the interior of a figure and go out. I think of a skeleton first. I never think about the outside edge of the thigh, right, that boundary, okay? I think of the internal structure of the figure and then I move out. So you notice that I'm definitely now concentrating on some outside edges, but the figure should be grown from the inside out. Okay, so I'm coming down here, again, a little bit more information. The thigh here is gonna be interesting because it's kind of a perspective of a foreshortening. So I'm gonna have to, you know, think about that later on. And hopefully the images that I've shown you in the PowerPoint, you know, will help you out with some ideas on what possibilities that you can do. Okay, up here again. Okay. Okay. Now that's enough for me right now. Next step, again, I'm going a little bit more faster with this part of the process since you saw the previous one and doing some editing now. Getting rid of things that I don't need just yet. Almost like just get rid of the information that you placed that is blocking the image. Things that don't work, right? Things that get in the way, the noise. You know, whenever you're making something, you know, there's always going to be noise involved, you know, whether you're banging on a hammer. Same thing with drawing, right? You know, you need material, right? But then you gotta take material off at some point, editing, okay? Again, I'm doing a little bit of motion on the interior of that figure, okay? Do a little zoom in here possibly so you can kind of see a little bit more of the some of that work here. You know, a lot of artists even carve shapes into their eraser in order to create kind of some interesting shapes. We're not going to do that right now, but okay. Okay. Now I've done a little bit of erasing. I'm going to zoom out again. And you can see that I have some tones, I have some shadow, and I have some information, enough information that I can later on go and edit in or edit and define. But again, I want you to try to make the first gesture as fluid as possible, right? In order to, you know, learn how to react to your subconscious, react to the vision that's in your mind. And I think that's important. That all you're doing now is just doing this initial reaction to the vision that you have, and you're doing your best to record that vision as fast and as raw as possible. So here's a frontal view of the second drawing. Very raw still. Haven't brushed away the eraser marks yet, and did minimal amount of editing. But you can see how I'm already creating a pretty interesting figure with movement and fluidity. I really enjoy kind of this arm here, how this is kind of turning out to be something interesting. Movement, and you know, sometimes I don't even want to complete certain parts of it, like keeping some of these areas right here raw and then really getting some detail inside the features and areas like that. So, you know, there's a lot you can do with leaving that movement and leaving that that gestural quality, because again, the viewer will fill in the blanks. And that's what's nice about gesture drawing, is that, you know, you're kind of participating with what the viewer sees in their subconscious as well. So leaving room for them to participate. So pretty cool, you know. So I'm gonna do one more drawing because we're supposed to do three drawings. And then we'll begin to combine those and hopefully a larger drawing. So remember, you might have to do this more than three times. I would do it 10 times and then see and choose the best three figures and then, you know, proceed on. But minimum three drawings, I think, is a good amount to practice a good gesture drawing. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and start on my third figure. And this time, I'm gonna use the hardest pencil that I have, which is gonna be the 2H, whatever the hardest pencil that you have. If you don't have any thing other than one pencil, we'll just go ahead. But if you do, let's try something harder, and I'm gonna go ahead this time and again start in the center rather than in the head. So let me go ahead and get, you know, a center torso. Let's see what happens. Okay, now you'll notice if you do have a harder pencil, you know, that you can do a lot more kind of finer work in a sense of the gesture. It's not doing a lot of rubbing, it's not moving. Okay. Let's see what happens. Okay, I'm gonna head here. Looks like I'm getting a kind of a profile, kind of a mid sideways pose. Okay, and the arms are outstretched, got two arms. Okay. Again, try not to lay that pencil down. Keep it moving as much as you can. Okay. All right, looks like here we go. Got some legs here. Again, I work kind of internally, meaning that I try to get a skeletal structure first, and then I kind of work to the outside edges or the boundaries. Right, try your best to remember work internally first and then move. Okay, now I'm putting a little more pressure now on the trying to get some definition now. Okay, looks like this woman here, I kind of believe, is reaching out. Okay, keep going. Now, one thing you'll notice when you do a harder pencil is that it's gonna be hard for you to erase. So, you know, you're gonna just have to be a little bit more careful and focused. So maybe that's why it's good to do that on your last few figures here, so you do get a chance to get the feel of gesturing before you get into something that's hard in a sense of graphite. Remember, I'm not paying too much attention. We don't want to outline too much. I'm working from the inside out, letting the gesture lines build the figure. It'll emerge from that set of lines. If you just keep moving and keep thinking about who this or what this pose is. I'm having a little trouble here, but I'll edit this out later on. Okay. Here we go. Okay, maybe a little bit more here. Kind of had a little trouble here in the arm area, but I can get that at some point. Maybe she's holding on to something. She's making a weaving of some sort. All right. Okay. Let me go ahead and move into some editing now. See how well that can be edited. Let me do a little zoom in here as well, so you can see how edit. You can see the shoulder area is where I'm going to have some trouble here, I think, or it's going to be challenging to get that perspective of that woman reaching out. Let me go ahead and see if I can get rid of some of that. There we go. Yeah, that's working there. Okay. Remember, just get rid of some of the, get rid of just the noise. Okay. There we go. Some of that interior noise. I want to keep some of that work. Remember, don't edit it too much, okay? Because you're going to want to keep that, some of that, you know, that information, because remember, it can create just tones in itself. It can create some good tones. Okay, trim down the, here. Okay. Moving down to the knee area. You know, and it really, you know, doesn't really matter all that much in a sense of whether it's correct or not. It's whether you're, again, you know, feeling that you're making some interesting marks. In the end, it's really all that it's about. It's about, you know, the individual mark that you make at that certain moment of your life, you know. And it's a recording of that moment in its own way, right? It's a recording of, you know, each little breath that you are taking as you are making these marks, right? Each heartbeat that you know, you're making. It's kind of recording it in a way. Okay, and there we go. Okay, so I'm kind of happy. I am happy with this this gesture here. Some information I'm going to need to fill in some of the arms, but again, I think that I envisioned a figure, and I now have this woman form that is shaking off or doing something with some material, maybe some weaving of some sort, maybe some sort of a making of some sort. Then I have some gestural, some hair that I can then get some interesting forms and shadows and tones. Okay. So here is a frontal view of my third figure here, and I really like the way this one turned out, just because there's a narrative already. There's already something happening that that creates some sort of story, and I can get a lot of ideas of interacting other figures with this type of a pose here. So, and I really enjoyed the way the feet are real simple, and they look almost like she could be in a river or a stream, washing, you know, some interest, some stuff, or you know, just whatever, you know. I mean, any narrative can come. She could be, you know, like I said, weaving and just messing with material, or you know, making something. But again, you know, really just have fun with your figures, and really, you know, try them multiple times. I mean, what's nice about this assignment is the fact that you can do this so fast, and you can end up with 20 drawings in, you know, 10 minutes, and then you can put them all on the wall and look at them and just and see what happens, and then chip away at forming them and shaping them and continuing to define them as much as you want, of course. So again, 3 drawings, 3 figures, and let's see if we can start to define some form with the erasing. And then going back in and adding some more tones, and that's what I'm going to be doing next, is going back to the 3 and defining and adding, and maybe even getting some shadows and tones or value to try to get some 3-dimension or something. Okay. So I'm going to go back to my first figure and start to do just a little bit more work, a little bit more defining. What I've done here is I have my 2 hardest pencils, which in my case are my 2H and my H, and I use the regular just pencil sharpener for those, so I can get a good sharp edge on those. But before I do that, I'm going to want to get my gum eraser now, okay, and I'm going to go ahead and shape that into the proper shapes that I need in order to get just a better defined edge. So if I could zoom in, and you can see how I'm starting to kind of define the edges of the torso and the hip of my figure here. And I also want you to get your brown eraser if you have that, because a brown eraser can be used. It's a more delicate eraser than your white eraser, but it can be used for a lot of more tonal kind of smudging. So try to practice using that. So I'm just going to sit here and I'm going to define some edges here. Hopefully get some shadows. Figured out. I'm going to switch over to my 4B here because I still want some softness, and again, just start to define things a little bit cleaner now. Switching back and forth. I'm envisioning a hand here. I'm going to go ahead and finish that one out. I'm going to switch over to my 4B. You can see I can work back and forth, you you a good shoulder there. And again, remember, you can definitely grab a reference of a figure, whether it's a photograph.
Okay. Or, you know,
even if a pose, if you have a, you know, somebody to pose for you, it's always a good thing to have too. You see how I'm beginning to define?
Moving from my
pencil to my eraser. And building it. And then carving.
So you add material and
subtract material. Again, just trying to define and add and subtract. And remember, just, you know, keep going until it feels good and you like the shape. You see how that
brown eraser gets that amount of
material, and you can really see how it can be used to, you know, take that material and spread it and create in itself a mark. And I think it's important for you to know when to appreciate
the looseness of your work sometimes.
Up here in the head area, I'm going to want to just to do just slight movements. I'm not really worried too much about too much detail. I like the way this
image is creating this kind of, you know, this gesture of the figure, and then,
you know, almost just like a memory of a figure. But I'm going to go ahead and just maybe add just some amount of features or something. You know, just some material there that I can then get some more detail, maybe, you know. Right, not too much. I don't need very much. Okay.
And you can see how slowly I'm starting to define the figure into something a bit more, you know, structured. Okay, so here is the finished drawing of my first figure. And I think it came out pretty good, a pretty simple pose. I've added just some detail in the hair, and I also got my ruler out and added something that they could, the spear, or just some interesting kind of separation of straight geometry and all the organic form. But you see, I haven't really defined it that much. I didn't really worry about going into any type of realism, just trying to get the essence of the figure. And again, you know, you're going to have your own style. You're going to have your own way of developing the figure from your imagination. Again, you know, you can always take some subculture or a subgenre kind of ideas from comic books, or you know, any type of graphic novels or any type of characters that you like in video games. But again, I really do want you not to copy somebody else's art. Try to develop your own figure, but you can definitely take influence.
But I'm gonna move on to my second figure now and do the same thing. So let me start to define. Always starting off with my white eraser on this one, because I have a little bit more. Again, you know, you're going to choose the you know, the proper, you know, erasers that you're going to use for your particular moment. So I'm going to clean up some stuff here. I want to be able to get myself a lot more space inside there, so I'm carving out so I can add some more tones and stuff like that. This knee here is going to be kind of a challenge to get that
foreshortening. So I'm going to do a little zoom in here so you can see how I'm approaching.
Okay. Start off with my white eraser here to get this kind of shaped a little bit more properly. Making sure the calf muscle is kind of showing up. Now I can move into a little bit more of my gum erasing and see if I can just map out that foot, just a little information. You know, hands and feet are going to be challenging, so, you know, just gesture them. You know, everybody knows what hands and feet look like. They're not going to be, you know, the most important part, but you always want to gesture them. You know, you always want to have some
information, right? So the viewer knows, you know, that
that you took that in consideration. Remember, they will fill in the blanks. You need something there for them to, some information for them to participate. Okay. It's gonna be a little more challenging here, but I'm gonna handle that later. Okay.
So I'm gonna continue on erasing and now building up. Erasing and then begin to build up on some more detail.
Okay, I've done a lot of the defining that I want to do. So you see that I think I figured out the foot down here. I'll zoom in a bit. But one thing I had an idea for each of my figures is to put a spear in each of them. So I'm going to go ahead and get my straight edge and see, you know, I think that could be a cool kind of consistent thing going on with all three. So maybe you can find an idea like that when you are developing your three. Again, you know, I'm working in sequence here. You can work any way you want, you know, or any sequence that you want. But, you know, that, you know, adds something that I think it's interesting that they're, dancing with in a sense. So, there you go. Okay, so here is my finished figure, number two.
And as you can see here, I think I figured out that bottom foot. A little more shadow probably could be used on the foot to kind of make it fall back in that foreshortened way, that foot as well. So you see how, you know, just, you know, you don't need to define it much. And of course, look at my hand. Very little there, but again, allow the viewer to fill in the blanks. Okay, and you know, you can keep going. See, I'm happy with what I have. I think I've captured the movement that I want, but you can get as detailed as you want, or as in a sense of you know, clean as you want with your figure, and more importantly, just, you know, have fun.
Okay, on to my third figure here. So start off with my white eraser. Remember the process. Gonna find that proper edge. Again, the same thing is, you know, you're gonna decide on
where you need
the information and where to edit out and where to leave blank for the viewer to participate. I'm gonna go back in here in a bit and then start to define.
Let's do a little zoom in. Leg and hip area.
Again, just cleaning up that edge. Moving on to the kneaded eraser. Remember, on this one I used a harder pencil, so I don't have a lot of movement like I did with the other two, so I have to take that into account and kind of decide if I'm going to need to add some softer graphite to make some tones in there, but we'll see. I'm still editing here. You want to tread slowly, and I really want you all to take your time, you know, just because the
video is a certain amount of time does not mean that you know that works for you. Spend as much time as you need,
and that's important, you know. At some point, I these should be your own creations, and you should treat them as such, and not necessarily as an assignment. Okay, we'll try to define some of these important kind of parts of the body, so it doesn't look too awkward. So I have a soft 2B here. It's a medium soft. And you can see how I'm trying to define that edge just a bit more. Get the neck muscle here. And at a certain point, you know, it's going to turn out the way it wants to turn out.
And
I only have so much control, I really want a lot of control, honestly. And that's what.
Okay, so I'm getting some interesting kind of results here that I enjoy. Zoom out.
Here at the hand and arm area, which is going to be a challenge for me. Again, now remember, I really think that what's cool is that you guys can use
references. I mean, you can
find a photo of the exact position and use that as a reference. And, artists always have used references. I want you to begin the initial idea with the gesture, or at least try your best to attempt to develop your own figure, but
you're gonna find your way.
Okay, so you see I'm kind of defining some of these ends here pretty simply. I want to make sure that, remember, I'm kind of dealing inside out and allowing
some of that information to be
figured out by the viewer.
I think once you figure that out, that
artists do that quite a bit, is they don't worry too much about the information. It relieves a lot of pressure on a lot of people, so it doesn't have to look like anything. Down here at the
legs,
I'm gonna try to get again a good gesture, or maybe how a foot would look. Side calf. All right, so just information there, just something again. I can get some erasing and do as much as I want. But you see, what you could do is you can just you don't need somebody in this particular pose. You can just find a foot, find a foot laying around the house or something, then just start drawing it in that angle. So we can work in sections, we don't have to, you don't always need the figure in front of you in order to capture what you need. Up here in the face, Make sure I get a good gesture so I can, again, get some information. And it's always going to look a little crude, or a little, you know, disproportion
when you begin a sketch,
especially like on something like detail like a face. But remember, it's you have good material, you have good paper, it will be able to be worked. And that's the key, is that understanding that it will be able to be worked. Okay, can we define maybe more of this? Hair here. Okay, now I'll switch over to a little bit of editing. I think I'm going to need an eraser here. You see how if I just trust my movements, and trust again
the vision that I have
while I'm creating, what features are appearing in my mind. If I work with those two types of concentrations, I think it's a good way of putting it, two types of way of focusing, something will appear that could be interesting. Okay, so I have somewhat some features here that I'm enjoying. Okay,
I don't want too much information. I like that,
Okay. All right, so I've done some work here, and you can see how I've developed a little bit more of, some specific traits. I worked on hair a little bit. I'm keeping it loose. But again, you can go as detailed as you want and, have fun with it. Trust me, you are going to find something, and
there will be an image and a figure that does appear. What I want to do lastly is to keep it consistent with my other three drawings. So I'm going to attach a spear to this figure as well. So I'll go ahead and get a soft. Make sure she has a spear too. Okay, and then maybe her spear, she has some extra, ceremonial ritual regalia flowing down. So. Okay, here are my three figures. I want you to try to utilize as much as the page as possible so you can see how all of them fit as much as I can. So really think about the negative space around it, but make them to scale so we can really work with them. We're going to be working with these figures again in another project. So remember, and you can always do more than three. I would gesture at least six and then choose the best ones out of those gestures to continue on with your detail. So I kind of really enjoy what happened here. I can always go back in and see some more or work on some more, because I do see more areas where I would definitely want to get more detail. So again, you have all the time to do that. And remember, try your best to get good proportion to make the figures look, to scale. But that's not the important thing. If it doesn't turn out that way, don't worry about it. Make it more interesting or interesting to your standards. But more importantly, try your best to work in a process. And how I did, where we do three gestures and then you define it in steps and stages, because sometimes when you develop a process like that, the ideas come a little bit more, you'll be able to catch those ideas because the process will allow you to stage out certain steps and certain types of decisions, and then, a process will begin to, develop into some meaning, some narrative, and hopefully, a proper expression of the figure or whatever you're trying to draw. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration, and I look forward to seeing some figures. Thank you.